Ellis, let's talk about Cineplex's latest round of earnings that captured Barbie and Oppenheimer. Very optimistic numbers.
Yes, we were very pleased with the quarter, and especially the Barbie Oppenheimer, which did extremely well for us. And we had some of our biggest summer months of box office that we've seen. And in addition to that, we also had Mission Impossible, which did really well for us and turned out to becoming our best quarter ever in Cineplex, even pre-pandemic.
Also record numbers when it comes to attendance. Tell us what those numbers look like, and how do you keep that going? How do you keep up that physical movie going experience?
We have, as I've said before, a fantastic loyalty program that allows us to communicate with our guests on a one-to-one basis. And we are using that information to continue to grow that relationship. And that's helped us tremendously, Larissa, as it relates to international content. We've been able to grow our international content box office quite substantially over the last number of years, as a result of having that data that we can communicate with our guests.
Help us to understand, given the current economic landscape, inflationary pressures, how do you justify to the consumer when ticket prices seem high and that whole theater going experience just seems to cost so much when everyone seems to have a subscription at home? How do you justify those costs?
To be honest with you, I think back to 20 years ago when the price of a general admission movie ticket hasn't moved that significantly. And it's still one of the best forms of out-of-home entertainment. And watching it on a screen at home is not the same as going to a movie theater with the big screen, the big sound, and giving you all of the benefits that you get at our locations. And you have so many choices. And what's interesting in the quarter is that most of our guests went to the premium experiences, paid the higher prices to get the total experience. When I talk about that, I mean like VIP, Ultra AVX, IMAX, all of the different offerings that we have at the theater. And to me, that's basically saying our guests want that special experience. And we are
Now,
still the cheapest, as I said, forms of entertainment you can get.
you had mentioned the pandemic, and Cineplex found its footing after the pandemic, but now you're dealing with a whole other ballgame when it comes to the strikes that are impacting what Hollywood is producing and those release dates. 2024 seems to have a lot of big movies on the docket. You've got everything from Deadpool to Godzilla to Dune. What does this look like now? What does business look like now that it will be impacted by these strikes?
Well, the good news is the strikes are behind us, and on Friday, the vote to settle it should be resolved. It was the best news I could have got last evening when I was talking to my US and California counterparts, and having it behind us is really positive. And the good news, it's not like COVID, where basically when you're closed, the movie comes out and you don't get to show it. In this case, it's just a timing issue, and those movies will still be there. Like Dune moved, but Dune is going to open in the first quarter of 2024. So there may be a little bit of shifting around, but the movies are still there for our guests to enjoy.
You and I have talked a little bit in the past about the value of franchise movies. And I guess as we look forward, and as you maybe take a look at what's happening in the theaters right now with Taylor Swift's movie, how much emphasis can you, I guess, put on franchise movies? Or are these standalones like a Barbie, like a Taylor Swift, are they dominating the landscape now?
I think you need a blend of both, because to me it's really important also to have original content that our guests come out and enjoy. The sequels are also in some ways good because they bring back a lot of the guests that enjoyed the experience and want to see a furthering of where things are at. When you look at a Mission Impossible, you go to one and you say, "Hey, I want to go to the next one," and it's a good experience when you're there. And to me, that is the balancing of both areas. And look, Taylor Swift did very well for us, and we are very happy with how it's performed. And it came at a good time because there weren't a lot of Hollywood movies that we were able to access, and some of the distributors moved their movies because of the Taylor experience.